Right, let's continue on, chat room. Up.
Congratulations. You made it to the red dot without dying. You are not Ethics Union scum. This concludes our tour of the Duper Genetics Facility. As a closing note, those cheap bastards couldn't pay for any more voiceover. How am I supposed to live on these terrible wages? I'm taking you down with me, Duper Genetics. You hear me? This whole place is going to explode any second! Get away from me!
Thank you again for attending the Dupa Genetics Tour. Have a nice day.
Solid tour. So those of you who are just watching for the first time, this is where the tour starts. And right here, chat. Continuing on.
Ugh, weird. Feels like I've been here before.
Oh. Dupe organizer, it's like a diary chat. Bill S. Occupation Security Guard. I really wish something really crazy would go down around here. All I get to do is beat down on employees who insult the company on social media. One guy tried to turn Olaf into a meme, and I got to waterboard him. Gets really boring after a while, to be honest. I'm considering applying to the government's cyborg program. I've been told it helps with picking up, also with ED, apparently. Okay. Waterboarding. 2017.
No, after all these buttons I'm coming across, I think I'm developing an irrational fear of them. But I can't pass up on a button in red. So seductive.
He's right.
What's that button? You want me to press you? Out here in the open?
Oh.
I swear to God, if you do any weird stuff, I'm going to be so upset with you. I'm not sure how effective the sun treatment is on buttons, but I am going to do it.
Oh God.
Oh my. Thank God that is over. I was actually a raver one time in my life. Then I was in a fatal shuffling accident. 10 people died that day. That was the day I hanged up my fat pants.
What? Laser pointer?
After each rave, a baby laser pointer is born. Rave reproduction is a strange process. Hello, animal distractor. I'm all raved out, but it might...
Yeah, we're gonna pick it up.
I used to tease an alley cat with one of these. And it got a restraining order against me.
The future's weird, chat. I don't think there's anything else for him. Continuing on, but this room's gonna be the exact same chat. Incoming. Aw. Oh god. Is that a Roadhog? This is my computer, chat.
It's me, John 3DS again.
Oh god. Thank god you called. Is the station still going to explode?
Oh, yeah, about that. I kinda made that up just so I could have a few birds over and have some privacy.
What?
You're always at home, mate. And AI needs a privacy. No hard feelings, paradox.
What?
Ugh. I'm going to unplug you for at least a month next time I see you.
Yeah, fair enough.
Can you help me get away from wherever I am?
Yeah. Nah.
Again. This place ain't so bad. Save for the underlying feeling of doom and extreme anxiety about why someone would teleport me through space and time only to be imprisoned by a talking water cooler.
That's a good summary, chat.
Thank you for subbing.
Restricts, thanks for subbing. Cupcake salesperson.
Cupcake served by a nondescript humanoid. Just like how communist mummies
make. Thank you for subbing.
Brisky TV, thanks for subbing.
Hello?
Welcome to Cuppy Cupcakes. We put the eggs in cupcakes.
Black Hawk,
implying that you ache because you ate so much because it was so good. Not because you got food poisoning.
The cream of the crop!
Whoops, $5 who says.
Thoughts on the changes to God, lol?
I think it's better now checking. Just spam it for me real quick. I actually haven't taken a good look at it in Twitch chat. I only looked at it on the better Twitch site, so. What do you think about the hand, chat? The hand was made more visible. I don't know. Look to chat for your answers, my man.
Why the hazmat gear?
Cooler thing,
dude. Pretty sure we are below the lethal dose in here.
Well, you see, I lived in the radioactive wasteland for so long, my body got accustomed to radiation. Now, when I don't get it and breathe fresh air, my body decides balanced to shut down. Guess. I'm breathing in pure plutonium now.
Holy shit.
I love the smell of splitting atoms any time of day.
Why the cupcake avatar?
A nondescript gas mask wearing humanoid figure isn't exactly great for sales.
Good point. Cheesy.
I also get way more matches on online dating sites this way. Although when they find out I'm not a cupcake, it's a bit of a problem.
Catfish.
We usually find a middle ground though.
Are these gluten-free and vegan?
Yes, most definitely. We make sure they have room to flap their wings and perch.
Isn't that chickens?
No.
Do you get much business here, or...?
Oh, you have no idea. Office workers' lack of self-control really helps the cupcake business. I just replied to 10 emails. I deserve this. I'll have one more cupcake then start my diet. Then everyone lost their jobs and I lost a lot of customers. But I've got coupons and memberships now. They will come.
Don't you still need customers for that to be effective?
Don't you ever speak ill of coupons again.
Alright, man.
Can you tell me anything about this place?
Sure. It's the Dupa Genetics main facility. They make prodigy children here, as well as other useful products. I have a deal with the CEO that I can set up shop here as long as I provide him with free cupcakes.
The sloth.
Although he's dead now what? And all the employees are gone. But I have coupons. Believe in the coupon.
Bro, I don't give a fuck about your coupons, man.
I would like to purchase a cupcake, please.
Sure. Do you have cash, membership, or a coupon?
No, I don't think so.
No cupcake for you.
Alright, man.
I would like to purchase a cupcake, please.
Sure.
Do we need this cupcake?
See ya. I'll peruse your cupcake selection later.
This isn't a cupcake library. Make sure to bring a coupon or cash.
Maybe I should start a cupcake library.
I like her accent, chat. Prodigy Child Chamber. I'm looking for stuff real quick, hang on. Alright, let's just talk to him, man.
These feelings. What is this? I feel a special connection with them. Look at those stupid baby arms.
It's a cat head.
Hello,
ew.
Prodigy Child hologram.
Oh, it's a hologram.
Man, I totally want a Prodigy Child now. Dibs on the wizard, babe. The more I think about it, it would be handy to have my own Prodigy Child.
Hey, dude. Last fan, thank you for the 5. Hello.
The more I think about it.
Okay. Make sure we didn't miss anything. Vending machine, what you got?
The cream of the crop!
Bordo!
I'm sorry I missed out on Tuesday. Loving this game. Variety stream moon is best moon, God love.
Thank you, man. Hang on, how do I go back? Oh, this giant fucking X. Hold on, I want to hear what he says.
Oh, man. This vending machine doesn't have a talking sentient sea creature as a cashier. What a jip.
Oh, yeah, the octopus. The drug-selling octopus from earlier. Blackest, most cavilt cassette in existence. Cooling fire. Okay. Instant Swedish person. A plus one life. I mean, I feel like we should probably go with that. How to get rich quick with adventure games. 4 stars, genius. Instant tree, okie bruh. Silly grandpa, thank you for the 3 months, dude. Let's get the 2. Oh. Hello? Let's get 3. Bro, this ain't free. I need that cash money. I'm poor. Alright, dude. The author of the book is the creator of Paradigm? Oh, yeah. Alright. Dunzo. Let's use this elevator.
Hey, sloppy down. I much prefer these to lefty-righties.
Thank you, Wolfwoods.
Hello, Elevate. We've hit primarily over whether that joke is funny for the 1,000th time.
Alright, can we use it? Wait, can I unplug it? No, go back! God! Oh, God. Complimentary high five.
I am shocked and appalled. This is the first elevator I've been in which doesn't have the smooth, crisp smell of urine. Someone in management is clearly dropping the ball.
Ew. There's a rat down here watching TV. Alright, let's give him a high five, chat.
Oh yeah, high five that. Yeah. Yeah, that felt good. Yeah, do it again. Oh, yeah, right there.
I mean, we gotta finish him off now, chat.
Okay, that's enough. Okay, you can stop now. Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it!
Warning! Any non-maintenance personnel attempting repairs will be bitch slapped if they do not keep it cool.
I'd like to avoid any bitch slapping while the option is there.
Also, if this is Bob, the maintenance man, for God's sake, stop forgetting your maintenance code! Write down the elevator button pressing sequence somewhere. If you're going to write it somewhere nearby, like last time, write it in riddle form so others can't use it.
Turf W, thanks for subbing. Also, apparently the code's around here somewhere. Cigarette advertisement.
I can see how this went down. Jerry, I love your design, but you know what? I also love fish. Can we get a fish in there? That's a terrible idea, but because you're paying me, okay. Nice.
The smoking
Hello,
fish.
Hello, manipulative advertising. Urge to smoke rising. This fish-based advertising sure is powerful. I don't need to convince anyone to pick up smoking.
We don't want to fuck with this yet.
Scientists are hot. You're goddamn right. Nothing makes me swoon like women who are masters of quantum mechanics. With them, you get lucky and get rejected simultaneously. Maintenance guys are 10 times hotter. Crude graffiti, bringing hard-hitting social issues into the public eye. I salute you, graffiti. Hello, second crude graffiti. Hello, graffiti. I will keep this in mind if I ever need to choose between these two careers. I don't think I could ever pick up confidence like this. Looking at the fine detail of the gum, I can tell that its user was 25. Male, pedophile mustache. How do I know this? Compulsive lying.
Yeah.
Kill old gum.
Can I take it?
No, gross. I hate purple flavored gum.
Oh, is that what's stopping you, dude?
I've got enough used gum back at home. It's great for sealing up radiation leaks, especially because most of Crucial's gum is lead based.
What? Ew! Where's the code at? Do we even need the code? Hang on.
It's a plastic dying plant. I was not aware there was a market for shitty broken down house decor.
It's got a name, Chuck the Pot Plant.
Hello, plastic
dying. Oh, it's a pot plant. Or maybe it is just a potted plant, Chuck.
It is already being used to enhance the shitty elevator aesthetic.
Jackie, me thinks for the six dog, ooh.
Nah, I'd rather not. Doug thinks that plastic plants are an insult to his species. But which species is he a part of? I always forget.
Spooky Bat, thanks for the 3. Doug is the beatboxing eggplant that has faked his death. He was our roommate. Okay.
Thank you for calling maintenance. Someone will be ready to help in 91 1,234 hours. Also, if this is Bob, the maintenance man, for God's sake, stop forgetting your maintenance code. Write down the elevator if you're going to write
it. It's the same dialogue.
Troubleshooting mode activated. Please input security code button sequence now. Press again to exit troubleshoot mode.
I think it's time to put in that code. You know, I got this bright idea. I think you should put in that code. Skibbity bop, bitty bop bop, put in that, put in that, put that code, skibbity bop. I was sitting alone and I thought to myself, you should put in that code. Hey Matt, I got some life advice for you. Put in that code. You know what is a beautiful day for? Putting in that code. Cody code. Code. I think you should put in that code.
Regular mode.
I don't know the code. We probably have to find it. We were in the offices, so we need to go to the lab. I believe. Oh god!
You can't speak that kind of smack to me. Just because you're doing it telepathically doesn't
mean
it's
nipples?
Not bad manners. You too, Mr. Yum Yums.
Oh god. Am I gonna get banned, chat?
Ugh, not this again. The names aren't demeaning. They're cute. Just because you're all high and mighty consulting me on corporate sabotage and money laundering, you think you're too good for the name Mr. Mittens?
It's a double-headed cat.
Yeah,
ew.
I thought so. Nothing else to say.
Hello?
Oh, what? Paradigm? We weren't going to liberate you till, like, 4 o'clock?
What?
Jesus, rollerblading Christ. I had the most delicious bread prepared for lunch. I woke up early for that shit, packed little Tupperware boxes. Now you're telling me I have to wait? Yeah, nice one, Mr. Paradigm. If you weren't the key to taking down Dupa Genetics, you'd be done. Done, Paradigm. Done! No one messes with my spread.
Sorry for liberating myself?
Done. Sorry, I just take my spreads really seriously. It gets the best of me sometimes.
What the hell is going on? I like your hat.
Thanks, I got it last week. It's probably my favorite now.
Oh god, that cat.
As much as I like compliments, I feel like we have more pressing things to talk about.
Who are you?
I'm the leader of the rebel group Baxt.
What does that stand for?
People against generally shitty things.
Finally, something I can get behind. Are you hiding anything?
It's her boob.
Under that jacket? Are you mutated too?
Nah, I just keep all my snacks under here.
What?
Super practical.
I'm apparently the key to taking down Dupla Genetics?
Yes, you're the all-important faulty prodigy child. Also, apparently, your innards hold the key to world domination.
Whoa, I'm a faulty prodigy child? That's a pretty big reveal. I feel like it should have been more dramatic or
heartfelt. He didn't know?
You know, the fact that I was born for commercial gain in the lab and now they want to dissect me? I pretty much knew that already, but you didn't know that. You're stone cold.
Yeah, well, I'm terrible at this touchy-feely stuff. Last time someone cried in front of me, I just pat them on the head. Anyway, because of this, the Rebel Committee and my telepathic kitties recommended I commission a children's book to help explain it to you. Also because we weren't sure if the deformations affected your brain. Read these first, and I'll tell you how to get out of this
mess. No, dude. Don't make me oh, come on. Your mommy is an evil company called Dupa Genetics, written by Pagst. Illustrations by Kuba Janarkowski.
Klaus was a big businessman with no ethics who owned the company named Dupa Genetics.
All right.
He set up head office in Eastern Europe to save money and avoid an ethics law holdup.
Okay.
He was Big Mr. Grumpy Face, hating almost everyone and every place.
Aw, it rhymes.
But he did love glam metal music and professional wrestling magic.
Okay.
He thought everyone was stupid for not liking both. That made him mad and sad. So he made an oath.
TD Crew, thanks for subbing.
To take over the world, so everyone had to listen to glam and watch professional wrestling on every program.
Really? That's his motivation?
He started by inventing the fully customizable prodigy child, perfect for rich parents whose biological children are wild.
Fapritizio, thanks for some. Oh god, I fucked your name up.
No longer passing their name to their biological shame.
It's a neckbeard.
The prodigies eventually inherit their power and wealth after their parents experience a bit of bad health. Little did they know, Klaus still had power over them to help execute his plan of wrestling and glam mayhem.
Oh god.
Meanwhile, he made Olaf the Sloth a living candy machine. Vomiting various candy every half an hour was his routine. Olaf loved Klaus. Klaus did not. Constant candy was the only thing he sought.
Hey Klaus, how are you? Okay, hey, you wanna hang out? Hey, you wanna hang out? Hey bud, wanna see a movie? Saw a trailer for I Want to Poop But I Have No Hole. Looks pretty scary, haha, should be good. Hey, have you seen my keys? Sorry I haven't. Anyway though, you wanna hang out today? That's so sad, dude!
Klaus later died of type 2 diabetes from all the candy. This made Olaf very sad and angry. Olaf made a vow on his deathbed that he will continue his legacy instead. The only problem now that after 12 years, the prodigies suddenly pursue creative art careers.
Oh no.
A lot of the time they do performing arts instead of business plans and pie charts. But there was one mutated child facing many tragedies. Not affected, he kept making commercial electro melodies. Now Olaf wants to give Paradigm an autopsy. The key to fixing the defunct prodigy child army. Continuing Klaus's plans to only make him happy.
Just wants to impress his dead dad, chat. You know? Sometimes you just gotta vomit candy every half hour. Mouth the artist, I'd much rather be doing my own stuff, but shit, man, I gotta pay them bills. This cheese and mac addiction doesn't come cheap, especially when it comes to my bowels. Nice picture, man.
I'm done. I feel like I want all my news relayed to me via rhyme now.
You can keep it for future reference. Did it make sense to you?
Well, slightly to me.
Yeah, we weren't sure how smart you were, especially after a few months of observation.
Savannah,
so
thank you.
We winged it. You beat into Hot Pocket straight out the oven every time.
Hey, I'm a Hot Pocket athlete in training. It takes serious commitment. Also, observation? I'm, not going to even ask. So now what?
Basically, we need to get rid of Olaf. Well, not we, mostly you.
Do we really have to? I mean, the whole world domination thing is a pretty big downside, I guess. Also, the part where I'm dissected for scientific purposes is not that great. But he seems like a big cutie. I just wanna...
Hold him and give him him infinity cuddles. Put him in a pram and pretend he is my baby. Post a photo of him on social media and reap the internet points. Make him a cute antagonist in an adventure game. Which one, chat? One through four. I need your help. This is story deciding stuff. I know which one I want, chat. Do you know me well enough?
All right.
Thank you, Exilicon. All of you guys said three. Three was definitely the majority. However, the one I wanted was two, chat.
Put him in a pram and pretend he is my baby.
That's true. He is pretty adorbs. Not that keen on listening to glam metal for the rest of my life, though.
Same.
Sometimes you need that doof doof or oons oons.
Yeah.
It won't be that bad. Honestly, I would be banging in a skin-tight leopard print.
Please do not commit this sin against humanity. So anyway, this floating guy here is the only person who knows how to get rid of him.
What? It can talk?
That's the problem. The dumb asshole tried to escape when I came here to ask him. The teleportation went wrong and ported his limbs around the facility. What you need to do now is collect said body parts and put them all in the machine. I'll handle it from there. Good luck. Oh, Mr. Mittens says don't mess it up.
Fuck you, Mittens.
Or he will passive-aggressively push stuff off your desk.
Fuck you, Mittens.
I'll keep that in mind.
Also, I took the restrictions off the elevator now. We put them on because of the 80% failure rate. You should be fine, though. You've reaped enough bad karma, I think. Just look at your face.
Thanks.
Why is she so tall? Oh. Headmart? I wonder if that's where we get a head from, chat. Hey. I bet this isn't even it.
Hey, this must be one of the scientist's hands. Oh, it's still twitching. You're just a little cutie, yum, aren't you? Yes, you are. Yes, you are. I said yes, you are. Jesus. Hello, dismembered scientist's arm. Now to find the rest of his body.
What? It actually is? Do I have to put it on him? Hang on.
Free limbs for everyone.
Yay!
Oh, no, wait. I need these.
What? Captain Hammer, think of the four. Should we push the mysterious mystery hatch? Copious amounts of coffee mugs.
Coffee mugs are the most abused of all mugs. They need the union or something. Fight for your rights, mugs. As much as I want to play Solitaire Remastered HD Improved Extreme Gamer Edition, I don't have my gaming mouse. Need that mouse sensitivity, bruh.
True?
Ever since Agnes312 Gamer beat me, I got serious with my solitaire.
That feel when ukulele isn't that good? Chat, I told you, man. Spiritual successors, especially, like, was Banjo-Kazooie even that good, chat? Come on, man. Those have to be nipples, right? Or maybe those are just the buttons on her shit. Let's hit the hatch, boys.
It doesn't have any handles. Just like I have no handles in my life.
Oh, shit.
Open up to me, and I'll show you a whole world of entry and re-entry.
It really was that good? Come on, chat, you just ran around collecting shit. Like, that was the game. You know what was a really cool part of Banjo-Kazooie, though? The board game thing. That was pretty cool. With the witch. So apparently I can't use this.
Hello, suspicious hitch.
I don't think I can do anything in here.
Let's see.
What? Okay.
I'm just going to stand over there now.
Okay.
Hello, ridiculous amount of computers. This is pretty cool. They're all connected together to work as one big supercomputer. I wonder what groundbreaking calculations they're performing. Wow, it's calculating the cure for cancer. Sorry, I lied. It's just torrenting copious amounts of mediocre, naughty sitcoms.
What? That wasn't 2000 sitcoms. You said a different word, chat. Chat, if I wanted to play a platformer where I got 15 FPS, I'd probably just end it all, honestly, chat.
Hello, large, useless monitor.
Not equals zero? Oh.
From what I can see, the scrolling text is just a social media feed of various animal joke accounts. Well, Ona threw a ball, then I couldn't find it. I'm still looking for it. It's eating me up inside.
A bonsai tree?
Bonsai trees are like the little people of the tree world.
You're gonna give an N64 game shit for frame rate issues? Come on now? Yeah.
Hello,
Don't at me, bitch.
Keeping the room together.
Check out this game called Yooka-Laylee. It's supposed to be pretty good. All right, man. I got you, dog.
Man, turns out this is another fake plastic tree. I need to find dirt somewhere else.
Okay.
Oh, man.
Don't at me, chat. Jesus. All right, let's go in the elevator. Oh. That's annoying. Arthur G, occupation accountant. I'm really nervous as to why they called me up here. I'm Arthur, the accountant, not Arthur the guinea pig. Dupa Genetics is going to be bankrupt soon anyways. I might as well tough it out. What did Olaf expect? He fired over 90% of his staff just to pay for his wig collection. Not to mention retrofitting a large replica of his head at the entrance of his to his office. Okay. Portals, thank you for the 3 months, says. I'm back. Welcome back. Chance, stop adding me. I think these all do the same thing. Hang on.
So many post-it notes, and all of them say, buy more post-it notes to look more organized ASAP. Signed Reginald Yoprosotosovsky. Must be that torso's name.
Oh! Chat. Is this the hipster from before?
Hello, redundant post-it notes.
I like you, but talking about Banjo like that, I'm gonna have to pee in your Cheerios? Alright, man. Do it, you won't. How do we get out of here? Here we go.
Hey, dude.
Toasty potato, thank you for the 5. Okay. Where do we go first, chat? The vote. Hang on. There we go. Which one? Not these two, okay, but these three right here. Acceptable choices. Talk to her again, I probably should have. Beep, 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 beep. Second arm? Oh yeah. Oh, I need the code to get the arm, okay. Up, down, right, left, poop. Is that the code? No. What? Where is it? Do you guys see it? I feel like I'm fucking playing Dora the Explorer. Much paradigm you played today? Not much, dude. Use the laser pointer on the cat? Alright. It's written on the wall? You mean this shit right here?
Scientists are hot. Nothing makes me squid them.
10 times? Or 10x? But like, how does that translate to this? Think, Moon, think! Press labs once and then something 10 times. Oh fuck. Yeah.
Troubleshooting, but please input press again to
I think it's time to put in that code. Wrong you know, code. I got this bright idea.
It's a four thing code, chat. 4-button code. Okay, not a 10-button code. Alright, let's go and use the laser pointer on the cat. I gotta cool off a little bit, chat. Too easy. Don't troll face me, you fucks. Too easy. Fuck you. I don't think it's gonna work.
If I want to be murdered by her, yes, this is a thing I should do.
I want your nips.
What's up with your cat? Cats? Sorry, I'm not sure how to address two-headed beings.
They're my telepathic cat advisors. Being a rebel leader is pretty hard, and they help a lot. Also, aside from their advice on guerrilla warfare and espionage, I like giving them pats.
Use the coin and press end turn.
Would you like to be my...
Come on, chat, this is the... Come on!
Sorry, Paradigm. I already have a boyfriend.
No!
Here, look at this photo.
Oh, it's gonna be so hot. You will always make my sauce. What was that?
A professional shoot.
What was that?
These gifts are always so thoughtful.
What the fuck was that, chat? That's a burrito.
Can you tell me more about the Bixts?
Pretty self-explanatory. We are people against generally shitty things.
Why are burritos coming back to haunt me again?
What am I supposed to do again?
Ugh, go collect all the scientists' limbs. One head, two arms, and two legs, and put them all in the machine. Then you can ask the scientist dude about Olaf's weakness.
I bet it's exercise chat, because he's a diabetic sloth that vomits candy.
What am I supposed to do again?
Ugh, go. And then you.
What else do you know about me?
Other than the fact you're a self-loathing loser who can't handle criticism and never follows through with his goals.
Oh, that hurts.
Not to mention whose internet viewing habits would make longtime fetishists gag.
Oh, that hurts.
You know, I was hoping for a more fun answer. We know your favorite color. We know that you're wicked good at making hot pockets. I did not book in for a day of crime today.
Now you can see why they commissioned a children's book to explain things to you and not me personally.
I've got this, this really funny story.
Sure, let's hear it.
Well, it's the funniest thing. Me and my friend went to the post office and they... It's so funny.
And me like, telling a story?
My friend is being all funny and stuff. This story was a lot funnier in my
That's
head.
That's literally me!
Yep.
I've got to go feed my dog.
Okay.
Kill me! We need to find this code chat room. Hang on, let me lean in a little bit here. Oh! No, that's not a chat. Maybe, let's see.
Troubleshooting.
I think it's time to put in that code. You know, I got this bright idea. I think you should put in that code.
Skip what?
Regular. Troubleshooting.
I think it's time to put in that code.
Wrong code.
You know, I got this bright idea. I think you should put in that code. Skip it up. Get it up, up.
Please, Bob. Try not to make it worse.
You were right, chat! Why the fuck did it fuck up last time?
I'm a maintenance man. I'm a maintenance man. Maintenance man. Maintenance man.
Take his arm. Alright, we did it. Now we can go somewhere else. Easy. Chat! When I tried it last time, it canceled out after 4 button pushes, dude. That was weird. Alright. Let's go to church. That's what you guys voted for, so... We are always right. So far, you guys have been always right. At least for this game, so.
She is some sort of glam metal grandma nun. No one makes cocaine like grandma used to. None of this prepackaged garbage.
Oh my, you poor soul. I'm so sorry the glam metal gods cursed you with such a head. Have a toffee.
Aw, thanks, grandma.
You're gonna have to grab it out of my cleavage. My hands are busy at the moment.
I'm not sure if I want...
Just take the damn toffee!
No, come on!
My hands are super sticky from the toffee. hate sticky hands.
Slippy shandy.
I'd rather be punched in the face and have it over with.
Also, attached to the toffee are my digits on a piece of scrap paper. Just ignore that. I'm not hitting on you. I'm not that into the terminally ill.
Are you like some sort of nun?
Kinda. Except ew! I can do whatever I want. Anything. Including playing lawn bowls nude.
Nice beard.
You haven't lived until you feel the wind between you.
Yes, yes, I believe you. Does it get tiring holding your hand up like that?
No. This is a divine miracle from the hair metal gods. They bless me with constant metal gesture.
Uh-huh. Isn't it just called arthritis?
If you want to die in a fiery mosh pit for all eternity, I'd keep speaking like that, heathen.
Can I have some of your donation money? Like you said, the glam of the gods did not look kindly upon me.
Oh my, I wish I could, but our holy book is against giving money to people who have no chance to live.
Wait, what?
Let's be realistic, you don't have much time left.
Come on, I'm only ill in a hip-hop sense. I'm not dying.
Shh, son, accept your death. Go on a bender, you'll feel much better. Besides, we mostly give money to the homeless. It's all in the great and sacred glam metal codex. Accessible to all glam metal churches via the .nfo stations.
Are you sure you don't want to give me some charity money?
Don't ask again. Look at you. You're about to die. It's against my beliefs. Read the .nfo file on the terminal.
What is .nfo?
Maybe the gods of glam will go easy on you.
Please, God, go easy on me.
Can you?
Certainly. It's the Church of the Latter-day Glam. It's just like most religions, except you can pretty much do anything. Mm-hmm, there is a demand, however, for excess. And this excess has to be rock star-like. You can't just play a lot of Sudoku and expect to go to glam heaven.
Okay. I dig that, chat.
Do you know anything about the Dupa Genetics plan?
Sure. We are supposed to become the world's one and only religion. My favorite part of the integration is our mandatory morning whiskey and cereal. For too long, irresponsible parents have been denying the nutrients their children so desperately need.
True. Twisted sister.
How do I join the church?
All you need to do is attend a space dust party for 10 days straight and receive an STD blessing. Would you be interested?
Can I say yes?
BYO?
Yes.
Sorry, I have some VHS tapes to return. I don't have time to join any churches.
Suit yourself.
Disappointing, Chaz. Looking forward to that.
Thank you, Twisted Sister. For your time.
The Church of Tax Evasion is better? I mean, I agree, chat. Can we just take money? There's so much money in here, you bitch!
It isn't morally wrong when you're trying to save the world.
What are you gonna do, bitch? Oh!
Hey! Don't touch that! That's for the homeless! And paying all the fines / lawsuits we build up.
Damn it. If it wasn't for you meddling retirees, I would have had it too.
One more time. Isn't...
Hey!
Damn it! Let's go in here, chat. Let's use the confessions box.
Glam at the gods. I have sinned. I have not worn eyeliner or my jeans from the women's department. Smite me down where I stand.
Okay. Use it. Come on, bro. It's
don't
time.
Mind if I do.
Yes! What?
That fresh vagabond smell that the ladies love.
It's perfume!
I guess cologne.
Becoming a ping pong champion is second on my list after being the greatest electronic musician in the world.
Can we use the cocaine? Oh, space dust!
If the space cadet has taught me anything, it's to fire taxes ASAP. Or you keep putting it off. Or you know, not get the crippling addiction.
Oh, hey.
Nice. I can use this with my Dupagen.
Music. I think this is the one we just got, right? Human sounds for whales relaxation. Nice. Selling to Mordlockians. Those are the aliens that invaded Earth, apparently.
This is a Pendingleworth's audiobook production. Welcome to the 6-part series, Selling to Mordlockians. This series will equip you with the ultimate knowledge to sell efficiently to our new alien overlords, an emerging market ever since the partial invasion. Our first lesson will warm you up with some Mordlockian language basics.
Thank you, Salt Corner.
Feel free to follow along.
Mm-hmm.
Doing is always better than just listening. Let us begin. Fresh human babies are not easy to come by. I can't just give them away. They are a premium product. That price is too low. No, I will not accept bodily fluids as payment, only cash. Excuse me, I do not appreciate you eating my family. Can we please get back to business? What's the weather like in Mordlockian this time of year? I hope the wife is doing well. Has she secreted her Regorgonhiger yet? I tell you what, I wish my wife could, but she is just a stupid human.
Thank you, Fleshy. What up, man?
Thank you. Thank you for listening to part 1 of 111 of our series, Selling to Mordlockians.
What? What a useful use of my time, chat. Hold on. A, B. All right, chat. Invulnerability code put in. Let's take the leg, I guess. Oh, let's look at this real quick. Old Man McGee K, occupation CLG janitor. The things I have been subjected to in this place of sex, drugs, rock, and complete lack of morals is getting out of hand. I wake up in the middle of the night drenched in sweat at the thought of the amount of bodily fluids I need to clean on a daily basis. How are they still alive? I've literally met and talked to an STD. No janitor should be subjected to this nightmare. I like how the game conveniently labeled it scientist-like. Let's look at the informational terminal first.
Neat. An info file on the virtues of the Church of Latter-day Glam. I can't wait to find spiritual bliss via my liver.
Same. Oh, God. The sacred info, the beginning, the Messiah edict of excess. Oh, God. I'm sorry, chat. I'm sorry for doing that. The beginning. On the first day, there was leopard print and smooth ballads. Then Glam God said, "Let there be copious copulation and gross excess of lifestyle." Cocaine then rained from the skies for 20 days straight, where Noah thrust fires are kept two of every type of hot babe slash dude safe, depending what you're into. Okay. The Messiah. The Messiah Glamicus Maximus was first born in 1959, and it is said that when he came out of the womb, his long luscious hair accounted for 80% of his body weight, which needed no product to stay glossy and strong. Nice. As our Messiah grew older, he sacrificed his time and money to live the enlightened life of sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Unfortunately, heretics rose to fame nearing the end of the 80s, naming themselves thrash metal. Tragically, through Glamicus's sacrifice to show us mere mortals how to live, he destroyed his body through his daily excess. This is when the CEO of Dupa Genetics came to save our leader, offering him to be reborn as a god with an invincible body. However, due to the limitations of medicine at the time, his consciousness was transplanted into the body of a pug until he could be transferred into his ultimate form to reign for the next 1,000 years. Okay. Edicts of SS. Excess. 1. Enough does not exist, only excess. 2. Respect thy dealer. 3. STDs are biological trophies. 4. The flame that burns twice as fast is twice as metal. Nice. 5. Skin tight pants are only pants. Only pants, like, okay. 6. Androgyny is a virtue. 7. A healthy liver is no glam liver. 8. Hairspray is the sacred aerosol. 9. To exist is to party. 10. Organic foods are forbidden. Agreed. Charity and donation. The Church of Latter-day Glam offers many charity and donation services, primarily focusing on providing hairspray and leopard print pants to the less fortunate. However, monetary donations are given to the homeless for the purchase of a glam metal album to begin the converting process. Look for large gray beards, rotten teeth, and the strong smell of alcohol on their person before offering a donation. Also, to note, never give money to others who seem like they are on the verge of debt. The church's money is much better spent on our compulsory daily coke parties and daily fines. Okay. I thought maybe, like, reading this would give me the opportunity to somehow finagle that money, but apparently not, chat. Crippo, I'm a vegan, yeah.
The scientist leg has become sentient and gone ahead and joined the cult. Did you really have to do this? Now I have to consider the feelings of a talking leg.
Man, I can hear you. You're standing right next to me.
Sorry, dude. I need you to come with me so I can reunite you with your head and upper limbs to form like Voltron, but with flesh. Not talking robots.
Please, leave me alone. Mm-mm. Ever since I became independent and joined the Church of Latter-day Glam, I have newfound independence.
Is it really that good?
Yes. I got these fabulous boots, my own room, and once I perfect my glam metal scream, they'll give me my glam hair.
Ow, my shoulder.
It's close, but not quite there. The Messiah says I'm only days away.
Please, never scream like that again. Is being a part of a whole body that bad?
The head has a foot fetish. Things got weird, man.
Do you ever have rivalries with other body parts?
Sometimes. We argue often about how it should be foot shakes, not handshakes.
Wouldn't taking your shoes off be really inconvenient?
Bah! You and the arms are all the same. When will legs get their heyday in society?
How are you even speaking?
That's a good
what?
Question.
What? You think legs can't think for themselves? What are you, some kind of legsist?
I am.
Hey, everyone, this guy's a legsist.
Shh, dude, I have other leg friends. Come on. What is your opinion on prosthetic limbs?
Faster, stronger, better, but don't have that warm sound, you know? All the same, I'm hooking up with a Paralympian's leg tonight.
Nice.
Wish me luck.
Break a leg.
You're a sick man, you know that?
Sorry, it's getting worse. I think I may be fathering a son. My dad jokes are getting so bad. What will it take to convince you?
There are only two things in this world that would convince me. A Swedish foot rub, or equal rights for severed limbs everywhere.
Oh. Chat.
Viva la limbalution.
I will see what I can do.
Chat, that vending machine is selling a instant Swedish person mustache. So we need the money to buy the mustache to give this leg a foot rub.
See ya.
But first, we need to look homeless so that we can take money from Glamrock grandmother.
It's an amazing statue. But all I can think about is that it was someone's job to craft some 5-meter-tall, skin-tight leopard print pants. Hello, 20-meter-tall proof of narcissism.
Give me money.
Kazi, 8 months, thank you very much.
Here, clan of the gods, will you answer my heartfelt prayer? Will you grant me glamorous, glowing locks? Guess not.
Let me pick him up.
What's the use? 20-meter-tall statues are only interested in partners taller than them.
True. I think that's everything here. We gotta go look for like a homeless wig or some shit, boys. Onwards! Wait, how did I leave? Bariko, thank you for the 10. Oi, mate.
Oi, governor.
How do I leave? Oh. I have to click all the way over here. You guys can't even see my cursor. Okay, we don't know where the wig is and shit is yet, so. Let's go to Headmart.
Whee!
No, I got it crazy. They've been doing that the whole game.
Hey, that looks like the scientist kid over there.
How does he know?
Wait a second, on the floor.
Robot, please! Ew! Come back! No!
I can't even get head. Literally. What is my life?
Thank you, Kirsch. Good night. Come back!
Hello, cutie bot.
No! Big D head.
Hello, cutie bot. It's like a mother to those heads.
Aww.
Eat your peas.
Meemaw, thank you.
Stay out too late.
Let's all practice our paper mache after stream.
Mummy very much.
Oh, God!
I don't think I can control it manually.
Okay.
Yeah. Outsprinkle sweets on your icing anytime. No, I can't. He just looks so content, just floating there.
The dog, in quotes.
I'm not one to wreck good vibes.
I don't know if you guys can read that or not. It says the dog. Jimmy Nielsen, Max Moifo, Mark Fury, Aaron Odin Jensen, Andrew Jensen, Serena Nelson, Alex Tucker. These guys must be like devs or some shit. Big D. Let's talk to him, man.
Hello, hit.
That's it!
No MSG. Efficient. Sensual. Gluten-free. Cruelty-free. Smells okay. Not a douchebag.
His name's Big D, though.
Fresh. Organic. No MSG. Efficient.
Okay.
sensual, glue, cruel, smell, not.
Okay. Another secret train here. Let's look at the one that is very clearly different from the others.
Organic. Or no.
He looks like he's in so much pain. Small fan.
What a useless fan. It would be better if an asthmatic with pneumonia blew in my face. Hello, useless tiny fan.
Call 25 messages. What do you think Paradigm smells like? Vodka.
The very slight movement of air particles on my face is so refreshing. I don't think I can handle the guilt of denying people the refreshing feeling of slight air movement.
Terminal?
Time to hack this bad boy.
Oh shit. Oh god!
Login details were admin. Thank you, IT incompetence.
Easy hack chat. To find the floating head of your dreams, pick the choose option and browse through a vast collection. Once you're happy with the decision, click retrieve head and Headmart's robot will bring it straight to you. Okay. We need to choose Dropophaga. Oh god. Trentius Fratus. Trentius only knows two sentences. Got any spare ciggies, mate? Got a dollar for the train, man. Everything about his head is gold. Gold! It's gold, Jerry! Gold! This is the one. Come on, bro! God damn it. Let's just go right there. It's gold, Jerry, gold! Siggy butt brain, that's what I thought of chat, so I saw that. You know, they made more than one video of those two characters. Onwards! There's a dupe organizer there, we'll get it, we have to go back anyway. Look at the top right, I'm getting memed! I bought this game, chat!
I'm pretty sure I had a nightmare like this once. I had to have a rap battle with Internet Explorer. Turns out the dude gets a lot of smack talk from people. So he had practice. Totally destroyed me. Damn it. This is how I die.
Yep. Hey, the dial-up.
Hello, okay. Sir. I'm from IT. Welcome to the settings room.
Oh, hello?
You look surprised.
Well, you know, IT guys are normally, a lot more greasy and awkward.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get that a lot. Pretty funny, actually. I can't blame you. Popular culture distorts a lot of reality.
True.
Yeah. Anyway, I'm looking to reset the router. Seems like the Wi-Fi is not working.
Oh, really? Well, I'll get right on that.
No! No, you fucker!
I'm a walking stereotype! Welcome to my realm of pain and errors. I'll never reset the router.
Why?
It's the only thing that makes it look like I do something around here. You'll never catch me.
Nice gremlin walk. I'm going, dude.
I'm not the same. Please.
Bro.
Good. Just good.
Bro. Really hope you weren't doing anything important. That would be a real shame. Real shame. Who am I kidding? I hope you were doing something important and forgot to save. Teach you to treat me like trash. Don't ever install a desktop stripper again on me again. Okay. Thank you, Dark Matter. It's reloading.
Ah, goddammit.
It's clicky.
It looks like Chubasa OS just crashed. We recommend you send an error report that will never be read.
Is there another option?
An angrily written letter using your own blood for ink, with a light sprinkling of airborne virus in the envelope.
Whoa, dude, that's intense. Can we tone it down a bit?
Maybe just a passive-aggressive letter will be more applicable to your conflict-avoiding personality.
Call that me a pussy, Dad.
Now to use my Hexor skills to rally the items. Heckity, hecky, hicky.
I don't actually have to send a letter, do I?
Ding.
Ding. Also affecting its general self-esteem, please take better care of the OS. They won't be around forever. Would you like to report this to developers or access the system settings? Settings. Can I deactivate that? No. Gonna do one at a time. The door appears to be broken. We need a pen, chat. Okay, to write the letter.
Oh God. I feel like I'm going to vomit.
What? Why?
I need to use for something first.
What?
Hello, Pin. I'm sorry I've lost so many of your kind. The pin is mightier than the sword, mostly because of the ease of concealment and the quick stabbing style. Score! I promise you'll be the first one I run the.
What? Okay, I'm glad I tried again. Oh God.
Camping toilets are great alternatives to real toilets.
Messing
Place it right in your room to save time on travel. Make sure to reply to all your scam emails. Statistically, one of them has to be real. Sometimes your computer may feel used. Be sure to organize frequent date nights. Ignore the judgmental stares of other strangers. Drill holes into your hard drive to give it some air to breathe from time to time.
It's like Twitch chat giving me advice, dude.
Drill holes into your hard drive. Make sure to reply to sometimes be ignored. Save time and get an Ultra HD streaming subscription with a VR headset. Better and cheaper than the real thing.
It's only about girlfriends, I think. I skipped the one of lines. I'm looking.
Rue amateur move, Jack. People use streaming services in incognito mode nowadays, so only the government can uncover your shame. Hello, creepy folder.
I'm using it.
Alright, let's see.
Don't ban me. Twitch!
Contraception and the rubber band collection. Let's go about 10 folders deeper.
No bans.
Oh, nice. A wildly inappropriate erotic novel. The jungle is full of terrors. And handsome anthropomorphic hippo man. And jackpot, a mega bro zapper. I've always wanted one of these.
What?
Pew.
I just got a gun. Yeah. Okay. Do I use that to kill the nerd?
I've already depleted that gold mine of personal horrors.
Shoot him!
Pew pew pew. I'd much prefer a moving target.
He is moving. He is visibly moving, you fucking idiot. Okay. We've got the pen. Now we need to write the report, chat. What? Okay.
I still get flashbacks from the babushka mailbox. I'm going to need counseling after this is all done. Hello, mailbox. You and your kind have brought me much grief. I need the angrily worded letter first.
Okay. What?
Every time I retrieve item, I feel like a necromancer. Rise, my wrongly deleted children. Rise. Hello, file purgatory. It's too high up. Never get the game bugs you want. It's too high.
Okay.
I need to use it.
We need to advance this somehow.
I can't. It keeps flying away. The emo. Waiting to latch onto some poor unsuspecting soul's inbox. May they not be overwhelmed and consider throwing their computer out the window.
Lock your size when you're huge? Oh yeah! Good idea, dude.
Let's check out what's inside.
Chat, you're so smart, dude. Holy shit.
Yes. Blank paper.
Did I get it? Yeah, it did.
I still need the...
Bro!
I can't.
Okay.
I need...
Where do I get the envelope?
I currently don't have the dexterity to complete such a feat. I really...
Shoot it? Alright.
Pew pew pew! I
admire. Nope.
Oh, the mail.
If only cleaning out your inbox was this fun, you could turn it into an FPS and make a killing on hits and gun skins. Take note, developers.
Why? Oh, to make it so, so it stop moving.
Before any emo equal rights activists come.
Okay. We've got the envelope.
You better take the corpse and hide the evidence.
Oh, God.
Who knows if there is any email equal rights activists around?
All right, boys.
A perfect, neat package of passive aggression.
Mail it, you fuck!
This better work.
Dziękuję.
No worries, dude.
Okay.
Hey. It worked.
What?
The door is back to normal. Except for this whole static thing. It feels like I'm dying.
Oh god. Go!
Greg, fix that goddamn router. It's been a week.
Router.
My internet withdrawal symptoms are getting out of hand. I'm getting all sweaty. Do you know how super irritating it is having damp fur all day?
Funny you say that. I have an incredibly hairy chest.
Shut up.
Yes, Olaf, sir.
And you still haven't fixed Krosh's surveillance network. What's going to happen when we execute the final plan? Do you want us to be the next Neo North Korea?
Yes, Olaf. I mean, no, Olaf.
Good. Oh, and one last thing. I swear to God, if I catch you posting shit memes of me online again, I will murder you.
Exposed.
Stupid asshole. Those memes are dankalicious. Oh, jeez. You escaped my realm of errors already?
Time to die, fucker.
I was planning that escape room for months. Months!
You mean it was just an escape room game? Neat. Well, man, it's all a part of the process. I'm happy to give you some feedback.
Thanks, Paradigm.
Aww.
Are you really a wizard?
He's like you, chat.
I've always wanted to be one. Any tips?
Why not an AMD?
You have to make sure you never touch a woman till you're 30. Then you become a real wizard.
I'm almost there. Nice.
Well, I was just joshing you. That rumor has been flying around for years on the internet. It's kind of heartbreaking when people finally apply and all they have to do is sign a few forms.
I want to boost him yet, chat.
So, why didn't you, you know, rat me out to Olaf?
Reason one, I needed someone to playtest my escape room. Hard to get good feedback these days, you know. Mm-hmm. Reason two, Olaf's new plan. Olaf's plan is better, replacing Claus's old one. If Olaf manages to execute it, that is. I'd have to set up an international propaganda network. Which means I have to do more than pretend the router is unfixable. I really can't have that.
Understandable.
I've got camping and fishing trips to go on with the boys.
That's a lie.
And anyway, Klaus's original plan was way better than Olaf's.
Do you know Klaus? How was Klaus's plan different to Olaf's?
Yeah, we were pretty good bros. Used to play handball on Wednesdays. You see, you were the original key to the plan. Something, something, the ultimate leader. Unite the world and end all conflict, yada, yada, yada. But Olaf was super jelly of you since he was only made to vomit candy bars. Hence the whole wanting to kill you thing. And I just realized telling you some of the plan may have, in fact, ruined the plan. So, I'm going to leave now so as not to mess things up anymore.
What about the whole surveillance thing?
Well, peace.
Bro! I had so much more to talk to you about.
Just move like 10 meters away. I can still see you.
Yeah, well, pretend I'm not here and just reset the router. Forget anything I said about Klaus's original plan.
Okay. Easily done.
It is not. Let's reset this bad boy.
What? That's not how you reset those.
Oh! Internet! Internet!
Nice. Wi-Fi is working. I can retrieve that hit now.
Okay. Goal!
Thank God I can finally leave this glitchy hell.
He didn't wait 30 seconds? He sure didn't. Also, it's 15, bro. Come on now. To headmark. You only wait 10 seconds? You're living on the edge, dude. Let's get our fucking head, boy. Price is not guaranteed. Frequently. Pengi Master, in a former life he was Lord of all penguins, then there was a political penguin uprising, now he is here. Okay. Oh, fuck. Wait, no. Oh, Arthur was the name of that guy who we, the dupe organizer we read. Retrieve it. Couldn't even give it to me, just got dropped on the floor? Come on, bro.
You're mine now, head. Oh, wait, hang on. I best use this shopping bag to make sure no one thinks I stole anything.
Come on, dude. Oh, okay. Look at the other heads, please. They're all the same. They're all the same. Okay, we have, we still need to look like a homeless guy to trick that leg. Also, we need to find the other leg. This guy in the background. Oh! I see him now. I bet I can't even interact with them, chat.
Nope.
Someone said there was a guy in the background. I think that's... Or that the light was in the hallway. Joseph Z, Occupation Admin Assistant. You know what? It's almost impossible to pick the right head for my coffee table. Part of me wants to go safe and get something a little more generic. However, I'm a progressive person. I should get a head, which is a little more out there. God, I don't even know if I'll remember to feed the thing. Thank God I can hire someone for that. Maybe I'll just get two heads. They could be friends. Okay.
Efficient.
That's a handsome dude. That's a lady chat. Oops.
I shouldn't use it for too long, or my nipples will get too perky. No one will take me seriously. After this all blows over.
Escape? Max Mofo? I don't get a chat. Oh, it's a YouTuber. Okay. I don't watch YouTube. Let's go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Oh, it's what we need to look homeless, chat. It's the night. Aww. He's bobbling.
Neat.
Yeah.
I want one. Sorry, Billy. I need this.
You probably shouldn't take that.
Fuck off.
I'm paid well, but not well enough to stop you physically.
You're not very good at your job.
He's in full knight armor.
Do you want to steal that or not?
Yes.
Okay. We've got what we need. Hold on, we're gonna go quickly do that real quick. Let's go steal some money from, you know, Glam God. To church!
Whee!
Quickly do that real quick, don't make fun of me, okay? I'm your dad. Can I use it on myself?
I feel Billy deserves more than this. Or at least a much more elaborate
Essence.
I'm just a memer. Thanks for having such a great stream and a perfect community for my memes. Much love, man.
Thanks, dog. What do we do? What do we do, chat?
I feel Billy...
Why not bust a cap on her? I don't know, man. Oh, I got rid of my gun when I used it. Go in the confessional?
I feel like I should be sneakier than this. Also, using a confession
what?
Box to take donation money, I feel like my moral compass is getting worse the more I progress.
Are you for real? Why was that the solution? Why couldn't I do that anywhere else? Give me your money.
Oh, you poor soul. Take some donations immediately.
Thank you. Let's go buy that mustache, boys.
I better take this off before I leave.
Nice. Fill in that plot hole, chat. Nice. Where was it? Right here? Why was that the answer? Streamer takes money and scams. Unbelievable. Alright, boys. We're rich. Let's get that mustache. Oh, I have to use my money on it. Oops. That's a weird looking coin, boys. No, don't eat my money! No!
Ooh, it's a baby. Damn it. Just out of my reach.
It's not even close.
Muted arms.
What?
I can get to it, but it's still not coming off. Help me out here, Hans. You could have belonged to a scientist that dabbled in radioactive spiders, but no, you had to come from a regular scientist with no spidery powers.
Is that the one I just
used?
Oh, they're both from the same dude, chat. What am I doing?
I can get help you, but...
What do we do?
Knife spoon is...
I'm gonna call this bitch so fast. It ain't my money! What?
Thank you, son.
What the fuck,
allowing
chat?
Allowing me to have a Swedish human without the messiness of natural reproduction.
Okay, man. Would I use the candy? I read someone in chat say it. I was like, alright, I wanna fucking try this. Haha, it worked. Alright, let's go back to church. Try to buy the tree? I probably do need that, eventually. Maybe we can get more money, hang on. Nope, head has been consumed.
It isn't...
Hey! You, but you seem to still have mosty and no b-
Ah, the dialogue changed. Dutty's on him. Oh, I can't move my mouse anymore, chat.
Would an instant Swedish person compacted into box form do the trick? I'm sure they can offer a Swedish massage.
You know what? That's extremely insensitive. But you are correct.
Boom.
80% of Swedish people know the age-old techniques of Swedish massage. Let's check out the goods.
Okay.
Oh. I wasn't sure what I was expecting.
Ew!
Whatever. I've had enough of this glam metal thing. Animal prints don't suit me anyway. Go ahead and pick me up.
Okay. Easy. I thought that I was just gonna put the mustache on. Apparently I misread it. Hang on.
I think it would be disrespectful to play with another person's goop.
Probably, man.
They died too young. Hello, melted Swedish person.
Oh, God.
Maybe I could use the mustache to pretend to be homeless.
PogChamp!
But I don't think any homeless person would have such a stylish... well-trimmed stash.
Feels bad.
For a goopy mess, I'm quite jealous.
Wow, why even get my hopes up like that, dude? Let's get the fuck out of here. Have we got... We did go to the lobby briefly. Okay. So we need one more leg. Just one leg. Let's all go to the lobby. Offices? We came from the offices, chat. Oh! The leg sticking out of the thingy. You guys are right, chat. Oh, we need the lance, though. Hold on. Because we need to get it down from there. We won't be able to reach it, chat. Hang on. I just saw the lance as we were leaving. Hang on. We have nothing to get it. breadsticks. There's a note on there.
Not a huge fan of breadsticks. Too nutritious, to be honest.
Let me take this bitch.
Hey, do you mind if I take this?
CD, what
do
you think of me?
I don't do much lancing these days.
Oh, yes.
It's enchanted, too.
Oh.
His name is Larry Lancy. Just ask him nicely and you can summon or unsummon him.
Larry Lancy? Keen to ride with me?
Yes, let us unite and bring pain and suffering to our enemies. And then drink some cold brewskis over their corpses.
You see, chat, I'm smart too, man.
Can I have this?
The shield stays. I use it as a trendy plate for my cheese platters.
Fair enough, dude. Alright, let's go quickly get the leg. I feel like we should probably talk to that guy, actually. Does the main character sound like me? It doesn't. What? Bro, come on, man. Lance is a homie. Ride or die, chat. Gloose, 13 months, says, Dad, hello? You thought I was reading it, the dialogue in a crappy Russian accent, really? Come on, chat. Can you not talk to the rat? No, I cannot interact with the rat. Let's see, check this shit out. Boom! Poke it.
Goes to show, even if you are crafted for murder, you can go against the grain and do something positive. Summon Lance Larry. Attack leg.
Goodbye, fleshy mortal. I must go back to my realm.
Later, Larry Lancy. I love fantasy magic.
Same. Hold on. Scientist leg, unique. One hand damage, 1-4. Durability 4/10. Required level 10 bludgeon class. Plus 2 fashion sets, plus 1 speed. Why does this seem familiar somehow? It's not like WoW. We got the body! We've got all the parts! Diablo? Yeah, probably chat. Now let's go talk to the knight. Before we go and reassemble the scientist. Words like, oh yeah, chat! You right? Man, Diablo is such a good game, chat. Going back and playing it though would be so slow. Free tree? Oh yeah. It's too late now. I'm already walking to the elevator. I guess we can go back and do it real quick. Activate! Looks like Torchlight 2? Yeah, it kinda does. D3 is great every new season? Yeah, I like doing stuff for a couple of days and just never doing it again too. Can I even buy any? Is it gonna retain my thing? We'll see. Oh yeah!
Useful sometime later. Man, I love collecting stuff for future quests.
What if I didn't get this?
This is what I need to defeat Olaf.
What?
Well, it says I need nutritious soil trademarked for it to work. That's where they get you. I can hear the nutritious soil barons laughing right now.
Woo tangerine soil, and you can instantly grow an instant tree anytime, anywhere. Woo tangerine soil ain't nothing too expensive that you cannot use it with. Woo tang! Alright. I will revive you!
I've got to use it to defeat Olaf first.
What? Did they mention that we needed a tree to kill Olaf, chat?
It is already...
I don't recall that conversation. Let's go talk to Night Guy. Sequence break? Yeah, dude. What the fuck? We did it, chat. Nice game, bro. I bet this guy tells me about it.
Good afternoon. afternoon. Welcome to Olaf's waiting room. How may I help you?
The scientist is supposed to tell you? Oh. Why the plate mail?
Why the plate mail?
I used to be a knight, you see. Saving princesses, slaying dragons and such. You know how it is, lad.
Cool. Why did you quit?
Turns out, as a secretary, I get paid twice as much and get a company horse, among other benefits. All without touching a sword. And occasionally flirting with the boss. Now, lad, which would you choose?
To be a horse? Sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
Damn it, laddie.
Can you help me defeat the mythical beast, Texas?
Yes, funny you ask, actually. I'm a freelance accountant. Email me at dragonsucks@gmail.com and I'll sort you out.
Okay, dude.
Is Olaf a good guy?
I know he pays on time. That's all that matters. I try to block out the whole turning the world's entertainment into just glam metal and wrestling thing. And that weird vomiting candy thing he does.
It is pretty gross.
Do you ever miss being a knight?
Not really. Lots of drama. You'd be surprised how much knights gossip. There was once a rumor going around that I was two dogs in plate mail. It turns out the guy who started the rumor was, in fact, two dogs in plate mail.
Subbing.
Wow! Jonathan LG, thanks for subbing.
Can you possibly help me defeat Olaf?
Sorry, I used to do the whole defeating evil thing, but, you know, times change. I have a family and everything. My son, little Joey, is a level 5 paladin now.
Aww!
He murdered his first witch just last week.
Aww!
Oh, they grow up so fast.
I'd like to talk to the sloth.
All right, lad. What's your name?
Paradigm. Wait. That was dumb.
Yes, you're right. Here. You're not scheduled for autopsy till tomorrow. Sorry, you'll have to wait until then.
I can hardly wait. Do I get a bowl of ice cream after?
Well, you'll be pickled and jarred after the procedure, for future reference. But I think I can arrange that. Just make sure to leave a good review on ratemysecretary.com.
I need to go save some damsels in Budapest.
Don't you mean distress?
I think I know a little bit more about knighting than you.
Okay. Observation deck.
I will use this to make an informed decision about whether star battles or star conquest is better. Well, whichever one can fill up my room with enough merch, rendering me undateable. Laser sword on the streets, Darth Vader in the sheets. Wow, this is amazing. Some sci-fi fanboys arguing about which sci-fi property is best. It's like a live feature rendition of an online comment section.
I can't go in there, though.
Hello, manchilds. How about we go back to my place and discuss in great depth the expanded universe of Star Conquest? My favorite is interplanetary space tech reform.
Same. Powerballs. Is it like the lottery, chat?
Wherever there is sci-fi, there is nondescript glowing blue balls.
Oh.
Both kinds. Hello, overused ball joke. No thanks. Nuclear power still treats me well. Glowing blue balls are too mainstream for me. There are only so many jokes you can make about balls.
True. Cursed flowers.
Pretty flowers.
Yes, but they are cursed.
Oh.
Anything that touches them shrinks. Items and people. Wouldn't recommend.
Noted.
Why would you touch?
Not sure what I was expecting.
Oh, damn it, you're an idiot. I'm only doing this for you once. Vanguardium imbecilis.
Okay. Probably need that later.
Currently, there are no damsels in distress around for me to impress. Nothing says boyfriend material like a fat rhymer and a dragon slayer. Hello, Chojoski Mart Dragonhead.
He didn't even kill it. He bought
impressive.
It.
I
bought it from a Trzaskiewicz.
Sequence break.
I didn't have the color I wanted, but I made a compromise. I kind of regret it. Its color just doesn't represent me as a person, you know.
Push it to the limit. The Pregnant Baby TV, thanks for the resub, bro. Nice fucking name, man.
Can I take this?
No. I paid full retail price for it. I need to use it for a while to justify it.
Yeah, you're right. Oh, God. You guys ready, chat?
Nice. I can use this with my Dupagen.
I mean, it can only be one thing, right?
Thank you.
It's Hamboning.
Hamboning!
Hamboning can save your life! I updoed that.
Thanks a lot for coming out.
The close mic talk. Slap God. I like that. Alright, hang on.
Ham boning.
That's all chat.
Ham boning.
Dr. Genki. It says, love you, Moon Moon. Thank you for the 6 months, dude. Stop. How do I go back, team? I forget. Help! Where is the end button? I forgot. Oh. Hamboni. Jesus Christ.
East and European gossip magazines are the worst. They consist solely of vodka distilling and sausage making celebrities, especially the Kubasaki.
I love that guy. So we could go in here by shrinking. I think we do that. So. Oh, he said he's only gonna do it once. Chat. Nice lie, by the way, bro.
It could save your life someday.
I was watching Joshua G play at Battlegrounds last night, and he was playing with Nadeshot. Nadeshot would not shut the fuck up. Dude. Oh, God! No!
Let us never speak of this again.
I can't go back in. Let me go back in. I want to see it again. Okay.
Then God the imbecile.
Mark, thank you, dude. All right. Can I use this?
It opens some other way. It's either a doggy door or a gnome door. Considering the secretary is a knight, it's probably a doggy door. Knights are notorious for gnome racism.
That's a lie. Nice stereotyping, dude.
Hello, doggy door. I've never been good at doggy style.
Hey.
Or any style, for that matter.
That's because he's a virgin, chat.
It opens him up. Hello, door impeding my progress.
What up? Okay. Get that thanks for coming out close to the mic be your new sub sound. I mean, I could just say that myself.
Thanks for coming out.
It's time. You make yourself shrink? Yeah, but I mean, I have a feeling I can't get to that door anyway. Time to reassemble the scientist chat. On the next episode of Moo Moo No W, woo!